Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. This is Psychic Medium Raymond Guzman. I hope everybody is okay. I hope everybody is calm. I know that's kind of hard right now with given the circumstances. I haven't been feeling, you know, very motivated lately to do videos on my channel. I think that's for a lot of us, but I these last couple of days have really helped me to find some willpower and also, you know, continue to do the videos that I do normally, because I feel like it's good for you guys, it's good for myself, and we want to continue to have some kind of normalcy, you know, if that's a word, some type of a normal, you know, normalcy or whatever, normalcy, however you want to say it. Okay, we want to get back to kind of like a normal type of environment. So I'm going to talk about the Black Death that happened in Europe, and plagues that have occurred over time. Okay, a lot of you that are listening right now, this is very serious, you know, that we are going through the coronavirus. Even though I've used my gift throughout the years to help people and help the world and do predictions based on things and patterns that I, you know, spirit shows me and what I see. You know, I want to talk about, you know, what is going on. A lot of people are coming to me, a lot of my rays of light, people that I don't know, wanting to know exactly what's going to happen. Everybody is panicking because there's different things that are happening, okay? Now, when the WHO, the World Health Organization, the WHO, gave that notice, they said that we were under a pandemic, not an epidemic, if I'm not mistaken. Honestly, I feel like we're at the stage of an epidemic, okay? And I feel like why this year, and that's what we're going to talk about, what I'm going to talk about right now in this podcast, this reading here, you know, this is like a psychic reading. I'm going to give you some insights into things that I see out in the future that spirit has revealed to me that I want to share and pass on to you, okay? Now, throughout history, if you look at all the history, there was the Black Plague, which is the bubonic plague. There has been the so many other kinds of Spanish flu. Then we had, you know, for a while we had polio in the USA. That wasn't like an epidemic, I don't believe, but there were just so many plagues that have happened through biblical times that have been documented, and even now. The question is, why now? Why in 2020? I know so many people are upset because you had, you know, your birthday party plan, or you had a concert, you know, maybe you were going to go to Coachella, or you were going to do this and you were going to do that. But you have to look at where we're living right now. The world, the vibration, consciousness entering into 5D. The fact is that many people are not in that level. Even though we have running water, we have, you know, things that our ancestors did in Europe during the bubonic plague. Like, if I'm not mistaken, it wiped out millions of people, like half of Europe's population, if not even more than that. Numbers are kind of skewed when you go back to history books, because again, they didn't have the technology that we have today. But the fact was that so many people died during this thing. If you're not familiar with the Black Plague, it was transmitted by like a flea, if I'm not mistaken. And what it would do to people is that it would cause all kinds of symptoms. It would cause like tumors in some people, to swell up in the armpits and the groin areas, like tumors really big. And then they would bleed pus and blood, and it would just be awful. And then some of the skin would turn dark black. Like, that's why they would call it the Black Death or the bubonic plague. There was other symptoms, coughing, fevers, nausea, vomiting, you know, all kinds of things you can think about. They had it back then. And their hygiene wasn't well. Now, when I went back and I did my research on the bubonic plague and how they actually treated this, it was the same way. They said that it actually ended. It lasted several years, but it didn't end until people quarantined themselves. They quarantined themselves, and they only went out when they needed to go out. And then they also made sure that, you know, the doors, the sick, you know, they would bury them in large places. places, like large burial places, and just throw bodies on top of bodies and either burn them or just bury them there. So again, it's like we're seeing what we're seeing now, the self-quarantine that we're seeing now with the coronavirus. History is repeating itself. Mother Nature, I feel like in many ways that this was predestined by the universe. If we go, like, the universe, you would say, has its own Akashic record. It's like where history, historical events, mankind, humanity, our own individual lives, where things have taken place. In many respects, our timeline that we're in right now in this century, this 2020, why now? Honestly, I have to be real with you. Even though this was a man-made virus, and even though some people say it's the 5G, okay, whatever. I'm not a conspiracy theorist. You know, I do say that it is a virus, but 5G does contribute to it. Again, those are just my thoughts, my own insight from spirit. But the thing here is, why now? Why our generation? And what spirit has revealed to me is that it had to happen because we have been disconnected from source. Source is Father God, Great Spirit, you know, whoever you want to call it, Gaia, Mother Earth, whoever, whatever you worship, whatever you have a connection to. We have become so disconnected. We have become so so robotic in many ways. We have not had human interaction in a long time. Now, if you go back and you look at the last couple of years, ever since smartphones came out, ever since there was access to the internet, which has been good to keep people connected and to make phone calls, a lot of people have been slaves and zombies to their own phones. You go out into people and you see people not looking up, making human contact. They're glued to their phone. You go home, your family is glued to their phone instead of watching TV. Instead of, like, when they're eating, they're glued to their phone. It has become so technologically driven that the, you know, the illusions that have been created in this reality, because I am a firm believer that we do have, like, the Mandela effect, other realities that exist, that there has been a lot of our realities being warped in this current reality, specifically the where we're living at on Earth. We have caused so much pollution to the earth. We have, you know, done so much that I feel like all of this, even though it was orchestrated, it's all written into the actual, you know, history, it's written and woven into the fabric of this timeline that we're living in. And I know that I'm kind of talking in a way which is kind of like way out there. It may, like, kind of be hard and it may feel kind of weird and cryptic for me to talk about that. These are things that I don't talk about because people think that I'm crazy. A lot of you that are awakened, though, know exactly what I'm talking about. When I talk about the fabric, I'm talking about, like, this matrix that is not seen by the human eye, but holds and contains all the data, all the hours, and all the things that, you know, all of our energies as a collective. I feel like in many ways, this plague that we saw in the 15th century, you know, or whenever it happened in Europe, it's repeating itself. Even though we have these technological advances, even though we have running water, we have products, and we have medicine to treat that. But, like I said, spirit, the universe, allows certain events to happen. Through death, there is a rebirth, okay? And so what is happening is the veils of illusion, money itself. Money is the root of all evil, even if we need it to survive, even if it's good to survive. It is the root of all evil. And I've always said that, you know, money controls people. All these people, at the end of the day, when we all die, when we all cross over, we can't take that green stuff with us. We cannot take the money and the coins with us on the other side. That has no value when we are in spirit. And I think that's what people are not looking at, is that what's happening now in the world is a product of our own evil. The our own darkness, even though we have light and dark and we are a duality and we have our shadow self. I'm not referring to that. I'm talking about the evil intentions that have been set here on earth. You can say in many ways that this is divine justice. And not only that, but that in a way, it is kind of creating the illusions and the control of these people that are in power to crumble before our eyes. And as a humanity and a collective consciousness, we are gathering together. Think about it. How much time do you actually spend with your family because you are working a full-time job? How if you are in school or in a university, how often do you get to spend time with your parents or with your boyfriend or girlfriend? The answer is probably like less than, 40 or 50%, because half of the time you're paying for cable, you're paying for electricity, and you're not there in your home using it. You're not able to enjoy the fruits of your labor because we are all slaves to a job, slaves to working. Okay, this is me, Raymond Guzman, psychic medium Raymond Guzman, talking to you in a very real manner that you probably haven't heard me talk about these things in this manner ever. And I'm coming to you today because I feel like a lot of you need to be shaken up a little bit to understand why this is happening. Now, a lot of people are complaining because, I'm here stuck in home. I'm bored to death. I'm, not happy. Blah, blah, blah. You are complaining. You're not coming from a place of gratitude. You have to control your energy. We have to do our part as a collective. I'm not saying that it's going to be easy to control depression, to control your self-containment and social distancing. It's not easy, but the fact of the matter is that you need to be grateful for where you are. I know that a lot of you are very worried about the economic things. I'm going to cover that a little bit later on in this podcast that I'm bringing to you. A lot of you are very concerned about your money. I get it. You need to, though, try to work and push past that. Use this time to reconnect to yourself. A lot of you don't even know what you want. I know this because I help a lot of people daily discovering their life path, understanding their life path. And I had to do that self-inner work myself, and I still do it. It's still a continued process. I don't know everything. I don't have all the answers, but I can tell you this, that all of this is happening is because us as a humanity, as a whole, we have neglected the earth. We have neglected each other as people. I don't care if you're in a relationship. I don't care if you have children. The fact of the matter, when you look at things from a deeper level, we have become enslaved to our own society. Even though education is good, even though things are good, to like have jobs and to commute and to have food, a lot of us are going out and we're ordering things. We have lost our way to kind of go back to what our ancestors did. You think in the 1500s they had Ubers and they had people that would chauffeur you back and forth? Do you think that they actually had like a McDonald's back then? No. Our ancestors had to cook their food, and they were a lot healthier, some of them, even though, yes, some of them did die. A lot of them had more wisdom and intellectual. They were more intellectual. They were more creative. We have been stripped and dummied down in many ways to a reality that is not even real, okay? This world that we're living in is not a real world. And I know that a lot of you are like, well, Ray, come on, you sound like you're crazy. It is real. There is water, there's air, there's people. But in many ways, you have to understand what I'm trying to say here. The illusion is that we have all been so focused on monetary things, on superficiality, on things that do not matter. And we still crave that. Like a lot of us that are going through this epidemic right now with, I call it the epidemic, even though people call it a pandemic, coronavirus, okay? Why are we going through this now? Like I said, it's to shake up the world, and it's doing its job. It's shaking people. There's going to be mass exodus of people leaving Earth. I have spoken of that, about that. That's nothing new. Every plague has had that. the fact of the matter is that if we use our time wisely while we have it together with our family, our friends, even if you're single and you're by yourself and you have a pet, or if you don't have anybody and you're by yourself, spend time showing gratitude, spend time in prayer and meditation and sending healing thoughts, even though you may not have those right now. Sometimes it takes practice, but we need to stay together as a whole group. Use your technology to FaceTime people. Be proactive. I think the message here that Spirit is trying to give is that we're going to be continuing to see our planet suffer. You know, Utah had an earthquake this morning. We had in Australia all those fires. 2020 is not playing with people, and I even said that. And when I did the Kobe Bryant reading, and I said earlier in one of my readings that I would not fly this year, the Spirit said it was not safe to fly. I didn't know this was because of the coronavirus, or COVID-19, like they call it, which is ridiculous to me. But anyways, I don't feel like that was the reason, you know, that Kobe's accident. I feel like Kobe's accident in many ways was a catalyst of what was to come. It was a big shift in the reality of people. And even though some people were like, how is Kobe connected to the coronavirus? Think about the events, the fires that took place and devastated Australia. Think about the earthquakes that we had, you know, last year, and that affected California and other parts of the world. Think about now this coronavirus that we're going through. And if you look at the events since 2020, all of the things that we're seeing is affecting the big powers at be. It's affecting the governments. It's affecting the people. It's affecting businesses. These corporations that have earned millions and millions are now crying out and saying, like the airlines, oh, I need to borrow $50 billion. But what about, what happened to all of that money that you collected as rich people? The owners of these airlines have collected millions of dollars, if not billions, as a collective. They have collected so much money, and they're the ones that are worried about it. They shouldn't be worried about it. It should be us, the people that own our own businesses, that are small mom and pop shops, you know, or the people that actually are self-employed, you know, or people that work paid for a paycheck under an employer, or work as a waitress and only earn minimum wage. These are the people that need to be worried about what is happening, because in reality, it's not pretty, people. This is not a good time. So I guess what I'm going to do now is get into the insights of what I see happening for the USA. Are we going to go through an economic recession? Even though people want to deny that, even though the president may not want to say that that's going to happen, the answer that Spirit has revealed to me is that yes, we are going to go through an economic recession. Is this going to go away within, like the timeframes that I saw that it kind of dissipating or kind of dwindling down? I do feel like the month of April, towards the end of April, May, and even possibly June, we will see lesser numbers, quite possibly. It could be the opposite. Like I said, I'm not God. I don't have all the information or all the, the insight. I'm relying on what Spirit is giving to me, what I see. But I can tell you that the numbers will go down eventually, but we have to work on our part, sending love and light out there. If you're upset and you are frustrated, you are contributing to this plague containing and being and staying here on earth longer than it is, because you're not raising your vibration in order to annihilate. And I think that's what our ancestors are trying to tell me when I'm doing this kind of lecture. This is like me talking and channeling, almost like on another dimension of a fifth dimension channeling, because I never talk like this when I do readings like this, okay? But I have set as a with my soul, with Spirit, and that's what I'm bringing to you today. And the fact is that I think our ancestors back in Europe, they could have had a possibility of getting rid of this plague, not only because they would have quarantined themselves, but if they would have raised their vibration. Back then, you have to think, everything was done through letters. There were no telephones in the 1500s. They weren't, you know, it was just letters and sending that, you know, from person to person. It wasn't like people had telephones like we have now to stay in connection with one another. So basically, I feel like everybody had fear. Everybody knew more or less what was going on, you know, but they had fear, and that fear was what had the virus that plagues stay here on Earth and destroy a lot of people, and the world lost a lot of lives. Even though it was written and woven into the fabrics of this timeline that I'm talking about, that we're living in, and now that we've entered a new decade and we are in 2020, I do feel that this is to teach us a very important lesson moving forward. We are all going to experience some level of awakening, and we are already in the midst of that. Like I said, the powers that be are going to crumble in many ways. And when I talk about powers that be, I'm not necessarily talking about our administration, our government. I'm talking about these rich people that own businesses that have become very greedy, very powerful, and not helping the poor. All that money is not good. What is all that money going to do for millionaires out there in the event that our economy and our world as we know it, you know, crumbles, and, you know, people cannot afford to buy their luxury, you know, flights, and people cannot afford to buy these Louis Vuitton bags, right? All this stuff, and I know that this may sound kind of aggravating, and I know that it may not be easy for a lot of you to listen to all of this rambling that I'm giving you, but I'm giving you what Spirit has given to me and what has they have revealed to me. And I feel like a lot of you could use this as a learning experience, and also share your comments in the comment section below, because I'm very interested on what you think, you know, what your opinion does matter as well. You know, very interesting. Do you agree with this? Do you feel like maybe that there's something else out there? But I do see our economy suffering. I do feel like this is going to cause a lot of people to fear. But again, we have to work together to release that fear and embrace a positive mindset. I think if we can do that, and we can raise the vibration, if we can do daily prayers, say daily mantras, stay in a very positive way. It's not always easy to stay in that vibration, but if we can do that and send that light out there, I think we will learn very valuable lessons, and we will actually annihilate this virus from actually staying here for a prolonged period of time, like our ancestors saw with the bubonic plague or the Black Death. There's going to be feelings throughout this period. I'm not going to sugarcoat anything. A lot of you are going to feel very almost like manic depressive. You're going to have experienced PTSD. I think there's a lot of people that are going to feel very trapped and claustrophobic. If you've never suffered from claustrophobia, which is being confined to a small space, it's going to feel like that regardless of where you're at, and even if you can go outside, okay? There, a lot of people are going to experience upsets, and people are going to start looting. I see riots taking place. I see looting taking place. I feel like it's going to get worse before it gets better, but I do feel like if we can all rise together and help one another, instead of hoarding toilet paper, instead of hoarding foods and supplies, that behavior is not, I feel like that is what our ancestors would have done, and that's exactly what led to this plague killing almost half of Europe's population. We have to think more clearly. We have to rise to the occasion and treat each other with love and respect and help one another. I don't feel like this is a punishment at all, but rather it is an awakening, a mass awakening of our generation. And us as the rainbow children, as the star seeds, as the indigos, our parents, you know, the baby boomers, a lot of them are indigos. Our grandparents before them, they were very spiritual as well. And all of our ancestors, I feel like from the other side, are trying to get us to that point. Spirit tells me that by October, our economy will be on the rebound of bouncing back. Okay, so I do feel like before this year is over, things will start to bounce back. It's not as grim as it is. A lot of people still are saying, well, how can you say that this is going to lead to a recession? That's what Spirit reveals to me. And again, I don't make sense. I don't try to interpret what they are giving to me. I always give you guys the messages that I get from Spirit. Patience. We're not patient. Spirit is telling me that we have to be patient during this time. Again, try to use this time to reconnect and discover. A lot of you that are listening to this don't even know what you want. And you know how I know that is because a lot of you are worried about your career. You're worried about your job. And that shows that they have control over you in many ways, that even though you have to work to live, it is a control system. And you're losing your own power thinking about a job. You know, a lot of us are going to have to learn and to adapt to new ways of living and new ways of working remotely from home. I feel like a lot of the technology that we have now is actually good, and teachers are now teaching kids through online, things that they haven't had to do before. We're going to have to do, we're going to have to, if we don't have enough ventilators for people, that's what's being talked about on the news, right? If there's not enough ventilators, then we're going to have to kind of like make our own version of ventilators and things like that for the public. And and you know, there will be a lot of deaths. I feel like that is unavoidable. There's going to be a large of the population that's not going to get this message. A lot of people that are not going to actually listen to what I have to say, or Spirit has to say, or what my other colleagues out there, all of you people who read tarot, all of my friends that read tarot, that are psychic mediums, spiritual mediums, that are listening to this as well. I feel like no matter how many of us that are in light workers and healers throughout the world spread this message, there's still going to be a large collective that is not going to listen. And a lot of those people are going to be people that will probably be affected by this coronavirus, okay? So I feel like there is a lot of light coming from this that, you know, even though this seems very murky, very dark, very, very, you know, hard to accept, there is light coming. By March of 2021, Spirit shows me that there is a new beginning, a new awakening. So it's almost like in a 12-month period from now, we're going to see a lot more success. There's something about changing in the powers at B. I don't know if this is with our current administration, but I don't feel like it's with President Trump and that administration, but rather as the world itself. I feel like there is going to be, I don't know what Spirit is trying to show me here, but there's something about religion itself being different. And I feel like this could be more of like new religions formed. I know that sounds very weird. I don't understand this. Either people are going to create their new religion, people are going to band together, or Spirit could be saying that spirituality as itself becomes a religion in the event of this mass awakening that people are going through now. So I see that going on. I also see the divine feminine rising to the top. I don't know what the actual contribution to eliminating this virus, or you know, what vaccines are coming out or medicines to treat it, but I see a strong female figure, something about the divine feminine actually helping to contribute to all this light here on earth. So all of our women, all of the divine femininity is rising up. This is a rising up of the divine feminine. And I feel like through our mothers, and if you think about it, a woman is very powerful. You women give birth. You give life to people here on earth. So in many ways, the earth is experiencing this. The earth is Mother Gaia, okay? In many ways, the divine feminine, the females, are going to rise together to have more power. Unlike when we saw the world wars, World War I, World War II, women, you know, and back in slavery, and go back in history, women didn't have they didn't have the power like men had. It was predominantly men that were in these powerful positions, etc. I feel like within the next 12 months that a lot of this is going to be changing, and that women are going to have a bigger role. And I would not be surprised if it will be a woman that actually contributes to some kind of healing, some kind of discovery that can help, you know, the masses with this virus at this time. I don't feel like we're going to experience what the bubonic plague experienced, meaning that we would lose half of our population throughout the world. But I do feel that this is a major awakening, and that this was written in it was written into our destiny for those of us that are living and breathing here in this reality, in this earth right now. And when this is all said and done, Spirit says that we are going to be living in it without the illusions, in an actual the earth itself is going to transform, and it's like we won't see it visibly through the eyes. We will see it in the fact that I feel like a lot of people are going to be different. People are going to be more caring, and a lot of the violence, a lot of the greed is going to dissipate over time. It's not going to be something that's, but we're going to see a large group of people coming together, and it's going to be like a new wave of babies being born. You know, children that will come, that will be future generations that are going to create a lot of good here on earth, as well as ourselves right now, the millennials. You know, the baby boomers are on their way out, you know, over the next 20-30 years. But a lot of us that are considered like the millennials or the XY generation, whatever, you know, you want to call it, we are going to be the ones that are taking over. And, you know, we are going to bring a lot different things to the table than what, you know, our ancestors have. And again, it's all about learning from this, from our history, from our ancestors, and changing for the better as a collective. So I want to thank you guys for tuning in. I know this was pretty lengthy. I hope that you're eating your popcorn, you're having some tea, you know, you're using this time wisely to kind of listen. I hope that I didn't scare you through all of this, that these ramblings that I'm giving you, but it is something that I felt very strong to give that message. I will be starting again on celebrity readings later this week, if not next week. I'm taking a few days myself, you know, to kind of recollect myself, focus on my readings, you know, and do prayer and meditation as much as I need to, because even though I do that, I've done that before all of this happened. You know, I feel like all of this that's going on in the world is bringing us to understand things a little bit better. So I send you my love. I send you my blessings. Stay strong out there, my brothers and sisters, and just be positive as can be. Stay grateful for everything that you do have. Blessings and love and light. Until next time.